For the most part, the video capture quality on the Quest 2 is okay, but at the same time, if you're a content creator or simply someone wanting to get the best looking gameplay captures from the Quest 2 that you can, the default capture settings leave a lot to be desired. Take for example this footage from Resident Evil 4. First of all, the aspect ratio is 1:1. This is fine, I guess, for the most part, if you're watching the video on your phone, but if you want to watch on a TV or a computer screen, then this aspect ratio just doesn't look right. When you're editing your captured gameplay later, you can, of course, zoom in on the footage to make it fill a 16:9 frame or whatever other aspect ratio you want to use. But when you do that, you're enlarging or zooming in on the pixels in that capture, which makes the resolution look worse. And on top of it, in scenes like this one in Resident Evil 4, when it's dark outside and raining, the low default capture bitrate leaves things looking pretty muddy and splotchy at times. There is a way, however, to change the default settings and capture your gameplay at really any aspect ratio and resolution you want, as well as increase the capture bitrate, making your Quest 2 gameplay footage look much sharper and clearer. To do this, we're first going to need to go to dashboard.oculus.com on our computer, sign into our Facebook or Oculus account, and then register as a developer. In this field here, you'll need to enter a name for your organization. Check this I understand box, and then click submit. Now that we're registered as a developer, we need to put our Quest 2 into developer mode. So we'll need to power it on and grab our smartphone or tablet and open the Oculus app. As I'm sure you already know, you need both devices to be connected to the same Wi-Fi network and have the Bluetooth on your phone toggled on. Down at the bottom, we want to tap on Menu, then on Devices. In the headset settings, there's an option for Developer Mode. Tap on it, then enable Developer Mode by toggling this switch on. If you're using a Windows PC, we now need to go back to our computer and download and install the Oculus ADB drivers. If you're on Mac or Linux, you can skip this step. I've placed the link to Oculus's developer page in the video description where you can download the Windows drivers. For those that are curious, ADB stands for Android Debug Bridge. These will allow our computer to communicate with our Quest 2 and change the video capture resolution and all kinds of other settings. Once you've downloaded the drivers, you'll want to unzip the package. Open this folder, then this next folder, and then you'll right-click on this Android_WinUSB file and click Install. Now that we have our drivers in place, we need to download and install SideQuest. SideQuest is an application that allows us to do a number of different things, like sideload apps that aren't available on the official Oculus Store onto our Quest 2. It also has some nice tools for changing the settings on the Quest 2 as well, which is what we're going to be taking a look at shortly. I've placed a link to SideQuest download page in the video description for your convenience. Depending on your computer's operating system, you'll want to download and install the corresponding version of SideQuest. And once you've got it installed, you'll want to launch SideQuest. And now we're ready to plug our Quest 2 into our computer using a USB cable. You'll now need to briefly put your headset on, and you should see this message asking if you want to allow USB debugging. You want to click Allow here, or if you don't want to have to do this every time you connect your Quest 2 to your PC, you can click Always Allow from this computer instead. You'll then get this message asking if you want to allow your PC to access data on your headset. I always click Allow on this, but you don't have to. SideQuest should then show that your headset is connected, and now we're ready to change our Quest 2's capture settings. There's a couple ways that we can go about changing some of these settings. The first is to click on this wrench icon here at the top of the SideQuest window. As you scroll down, the first one that deals with the video capture is this one, Full Rate Capture. By default, the Quest 2 captures at 30 FPS. Turning this option on will instead record our gameplay at 60 or 72 FPS, depending on the game. The next setting we want to look at is Set Video Capture Size. Here we have three choices: 480 sets the capture resolution to 640 by 480, which is an aspect ratio of 4:3. 720 sets the capture resolution to 1280 by 720, and 1080 to 1920 by 1080, both of which are an aspect ratio of 16 by 9. Unfortunately, there is currently no way to change the capture bitrate on the Quest 2 from this menu. So now I'm going to show you the other way to change settings, which does allow you to change the capture bitrate, as well as set any capture resolution or aspect ratio you want. We're now going to click on this icon here, which will let us run ADB commands on our Quest 2, and click on Custom Command. By default, the Quest 2 captures at 1024 by 1024 at 30 FPS with a bitrate of 5 megabits per second. Using ADB commands, we can change all these parameters to whatever we want them to be. We just need to know which commands to use. In the video description, I've placed the four different commands we're going to be using in this video. So all you have to do is copy and paste these commands one at a time into this command line here, and then change the value at the end to whatever value you want to try. The first command we're going to put in is to set the capture width. So in this line, we need to type ADB space shell space setprop space debug.oculus.capture.width, followed by one more space, and then the value we want for the width of our video capture. For this tutorial, I'm going to put in 1440 and then click Run Command. Next, we need to set the height of our capture. This command is almost exactly the same as the command for the width, so we just need to replace the word width here with height and enter our height value, which I'm going to use 1080, and then click Run Command. Next, we're going to set the capture bitrate. The command for this is, once again, almost the same as our previous two, but here, instead of height, we want to change that to bitrate, and then we'll enter our value in bits per second. The default is 5 megabits per second, or 5 million bits per second, so we want to be higher than that. I've found a bitrate of 25 million or 30 million looks the best. Once you've got your desired bitrate entered, hit Run Command, and now we're on to our final command. This one will set the frame rate to full, and that command is ADB space shell space setprop space debug.oculus.fullRateCapture, making sure to capitalize the words rate and capture like this, then space, and finally we'll enter our value, which we want to be 1. Hit Run Command, and now our Quest 2 is ready to capture some gameplay. As you can see, the settings I used give us an aspect ratio of 1.33 to 1. And not 16 by 9, but since it was captured at a higher resolution, if you want to go to 16 by 9, you can zoom in your editing software like this without losing much quality. Of course, you're welcome to try capturing at 1920 by 1080 or any other resolution. Just be aware, depending on the game, you will have to adjust the capture values somewhat. If you set them too high, then you will see noticeable dips to the frame rate, as well as get some artifacting. So there is kind of a delicate balance you need to find to get the best capture quality as well as acceptable game performance. Also, it's important to know that changing these settings is only temporary. As long as you don't power your Quest 2 all the way down or reboot it, the settings will remain in place. However, once you do either of those things, all your settings will be returned to default. The good thing about this is if you change a setting that really messes things up, all you have to do is reboot your Quest 2, and everything will return to normal.